Hey guys, it's JamKeel1 giving you zombies. We're on the map farm. It's two player. It's me and my bro, Barnabas Vamp 2448. You can add him. Frickin', just join him. Join this frickin' party, man. Yeah, enough with the introductions. We're giving you the gameplay, like I told you guys, that I'm going to give you some background, like a big, like several parts of the gameplay, like a big glimpse on how great we do in zombies. Now, we did notice, like I said, this is just like a private match, not public. And we were kind of disappointed that none of our scores went up. But anyways, I do have a few topics to cover down, and it may be a little bit long. I can still add it in the next part, so be aware of that. Like I hear everyone, partnered or not partnered on YouTube, and people on my PSN, keep on talking about the bugs, the glitches and whatnot. Now, glitches, that's easy to comprehend, and it's understandable. The bugs, there are more bugs in this game than in, people say, Modern Warfare 3, I suppose. I wouldn't know because I didn't get MW3 in the beginning, but I was dying to, but things started to fall apart, and I had to think, should I get MW3 or the S video card for my dad, you know, better quality. But yeah, everyone's talking about the buds, and what I can see is that there's a lot, from theater mode to the player cards to the weapon ammunition to the class, the Kratos class board, and freezing. Now, when I first got the game, I'm gonna put you on my part on. When I first got the game, I mean, it was just fairly simple. I tried everything out, and then right when I started going to like multiplayer zombies and whatnot, I think it was zombies first. What I did find out is that the game froze. It's a new game, beta version, people call it. And it happens. Every new game freezes at least once in a while. And then it starts to freeze more. And I start to get pissed, and then I start to go ape on how the hell is it freezing this way. And I'm looking online, like there's a lot, I'm looking online for like concerns and questions, everything, and even people from both PS3 and Xbox are getting their game froze in different parts. Like for me, like multiplayer, let's go to multiplayer for a good source of an example. Freezing in multiplayer happens like more than zombies does, in my opinion. And I think I see it more because it could happen during a loading session, or it could happen during gameplay. And for me, the game always like stopped at me, like froze on me, like twice. And that was like during the menu, the lobby, the pre-lobby. I think a gameplay one. I don't know, but I was severely pissed, and I was doing pretty good. I was doing good in one of the gameplays. Zombies. Now, I know people have been talking about there's, like, a lot of different glitches, bugs, and zombies. I haven't seen any really bugs, but I do find a lot of freezing. Glitches, I'm not really sure because I haven't really learned any or seen any. That's because I'm not really searching for anyone else's videos or glitches. Like, cheating for glitches. You know what I mean? For freezing, oh boy, where do I start? Freezing for me happens when people leave. Like for, what is it? Greet. When these newbie hotshot rookies thinking they're all badass and thinking that they're going to win. Well, needless to say, we kept on beating them so bad, one or two leave. And then when the, like, third person leaves, the game freezes, and it's going through that internet, like, that connection interruption type of deal, you get what I mean? And we could still move around, but our bodies can't, by viewing the other players. Which really pisses me and my friends off. And I'm just saying my piece on my side about this. Because I bet most of you would agree. Because this happens a lot. I don't care if it happens on both the consoles. If people are going to argue that it happens more on PlayStation than Xbox, well, fuck off. I don't want to hear it. Both of the consoles have problems. When it has a new game, there's going to be a lot of problems. Like, I seen this guy that I talked about, the Schwanz 27, posted a lot of bugs, and he plays on Xbox. And I don't have an Xbox. I don't. And even though people want me to get it, I just don't want to. Because if I wanted to buy an Xbox, I would have to get myself a job to pay for the online crap. And I am not close to read job positioning. You get what I mean. And I don't know, there's a lot of freezing, there's a lot of bugs, but yeah. And like when the players stop, and then they'll just keep going and going for, like, I don't know, 45 minutes. Let's say 45 minutes. And then the game will freeze. The whole game will freeze. But you can still manage to edge out the game. You know what that really means? That could lead to not really save points at the moment. Because if you leave the game, your points will not be saved. Or your stats, whatever. And you could be easily fucked in the head. Due to these stupid unsportsmanship-like fuck-ups. Pardon my French. But that's what mostly people are. That they can't play a good game, even though if you're going to lose. If you're going to lose, stick with it. You're still going to get stats, points, you're going to get your ranking system, your skull with the glowing eyes, or the knife in the head, whatever. Whatever. I just don't want my games to freeze due to players that want to lead due to that we're winning and they're losing. I just don't understand the concept of that. Now, like, Jake from the Magwoo said that people, like, Treyarch is making PS3 players go through more problems than an Xbox, thinking that Treyarch, Activision, whatever, hates PS3 players. And he's as telling them, like, what the fuck? Why are you hating us? We didn't do anything wrong. And, like I said, it don't matter. We've had problems since freaking Call of Duty Modern Warfare, World at War, Modern Warfare 2, and it's still gonna keep going on and on. I just don't want to hear these arguments of which console is better. They all have problems, and it could take longer to fix those problems. I'm just saying that we don't care what you think. It's your opinion. Just stick with it. Don't argue about it all damn day long. That's not what really YouTube was really designed for. Well, that's something I never say today. Whatever. Like I said, it happened. We just have to stick with it. Just be patient. Now I know I'm gonna get hate when I say this. Black Ops 2 is very good. The game is fast paced. The only thing that I hate of it is, you guessed it, the freezing, I guess bugs, since I haven't really seen any bugs, glitches. Just a lot of lagging. I've seen a lot of lagging in the game. Like, there are several players jerking and they manage to kill one person, even though he's shooting out. And everyone's talking about the hit markers, even though the hit markers are actually, I guess, fixed. That these guys will actually die faster now. Oh boy. And then I see that for the player cards, when you get your player card, like, in just a simple little formation, like a, let's say, a dolphin. Just an example, a dolphin. And then when you leave the player card thing, your dolphin is in the game lobby screen with it. Oh boy, we're in trouble. Not only that, this bug don't make any probable sense. I mean, wow, Treyarch. Are you that behind? Are these like corrupted files that you kept when the game was being produced and put all together? Could you at least took out some of the corrupted files when you were making this, so you could have at least a good game without having so many problems? Another type of bug is the ammo bug. Like, okay, I think, oh man, it's been a while. When it happens, oh boy. When you go through like half a clip, like you go until you hit like 14, you have 14 rounds left, and then you die, and then you appear, and then you still have like 14 rounds left, and you're still shooting. I don't know if that's like a bug, or is that a way to make people more pissed off. Now, don't go rape on me. I just seen other people's things like bugs, and this was on Xbox. I'm not really like disrespect to Xbox, but I just want to really talk about our bugs people have. But yeah, the ammo bug could be a slight problem. I don't know. I only seen like one patch. I don't know if there's a new patch, like an update. I only seen one update, well, two, when you first get the game. The camo bug. I didn't really watch the full video of it, but what I could see is, like, I think the camo will change differently, or the camo will be like very different even though you have it saved on there. Oh, yes. Theater mode. Theater mode. He has a few problems of what I see and what people else have. Like, when you go to, like, yourself in a, like, a free cam, third person, you can't really see your name. Or if you're just at free cam altogether and you can move your camera around, you can't see your name. That's kind of fucked up. I thought Black Ops, the first one, had these props, but I guess I was wrong. Dang. Those aren't the only bugs I could really think of. So, yeah, that's mostly the bugs I think of. Wait a minute. I just forgot one. This is a, like a really bug that could really piss you off if you ain't throwing it in the right spot. Okay. Like, if you're throwing a care package, let's say it's on Newtown, 2025. You throw a care package, like, at that air hockey thing in one of the spawn points at one of the houses. Like, the backyard fence, whatever. And then the care patch lands, and then it bounces at least, I don't know, like, almost 10 to 12 feet high in the air, and then flies over out of bounds, and you can't get to it. That is a bug that needs to be fixed. I mean, really. Is Treyarch actually making these people lose their stuff because of their stupidity? I don't know. It's so cruel. If they say it was just an accident, okay. If it was an accident and they didn't do it on purpose, I'll blame for that. But that Earth's crap, the freezing thing, that needs to be fixed. I don't know if it's been fixed or passed because I haven't played Black Ops 2 in a few days. Since there's no one really on. No one's invited me to any of these games, but whatever. I've been mostly playing GTA 4, so... And I just realized something. Like, you know, GTA 4, people who play GTA 4 should know this. When you come across hackers, like if we're in Call of Duty, people would mostly complain about hackers and how they cheat and they have no lives. Or balls, pussy, whatever. And they're scary cats. Excuse me. I hate doing that. But anyways, like, you come across hackers in Call of Duty and everyone hates people using hacks. And they get pissed and say they got no balls or whatnot. But when you come across GTA 4, people are actually saying that people want to know about these hacks. And these hacks are actually, well, usable and playable, in my opinion. The only reason why I think they're playable is because you have different type of hacks, mods, or type of options to have for your hacks. Like, you can make your cars invincible, your player invincible, you have unlimited ammo, you know, shit like that. You can make the weapons more destructible and kill people more, or have no cop wide level. I mean, we know that everyone's saying that these little kids, like at least the young 12 and under, like these hacks. And while that's going on, luckily I'm at least 17 years old, so I don't really like using hacks. I just